大家下午好啊！首先咧，歡迎大家嚟到今日嘅 Esri China Hong Kong 舉辦嘅 Webinar。我係今日嘅主持Kevin Chan。嚟緊咧，Esri 將會舉辦更加多唔同主題嘅 Webinar，希望大家可以多多支持。我諗大家都知今日嘅 Webinar 嘅主題係咩㗎啦？咁咧就係咧 ArcGIS GeoEvent Server。Real-time mapping and analytics。咁咧，我就 Kevin Chan 啦。咁我身邊咧就有兩位同事係負責 technical sharing 同埋 demonstration 嘅。佢分別係 Candid Cam 同埋 Jonathan Lau。嚟緊咧個 agenda 咧主要分為六個部分。第一部分咧就我咧同大家簡單介紹下咩叫做 ArcGIS GeoEvent Server。接住落嚟咧就會由 Candid 就會同我哋介紹 key product capability 嘅。第三個部分咧，就係究竟點樣透過 ArcGIS 做 event server 就去做一啲 collect 一啲 real time data 嘅。咁第四部分咧，就係話UC 我哋 UC 今年 UC 完咗啦。咁究竟喺 ArcGIS 做 event server 入邊會有啲咩新嘅 capability 同 functions 咧？咁去到第五部分咧。Jonathan 就會幫我哋做一個 demonstration，佢一共咧就會有兩個 demo 做俾我哋睇嘅。好，到最後一個部分咧就係 Q&A 啦。好，首先就由我去介紹下一啲我哋而家我哋 Esri 嘅 server role 嘅 focus 嘅 capability。首先一開始就介紹我哋個 GIS server。GIS server 係一個我哋 back end 嘅一個。server role 嘅一個其中一個 software component，佢主要係做一啲 geographic information，可以將佢放喺我哋嘅 web GIS 嘅平台上面，咁從而可以去disseminate 或者 share 你哋嘅web GIS 啦，to 你哋嘅 organisation 或者你哋 partners 嘅。咁接住落嚟就會介紹 image server。咁 image server 顧名思義就係佢會處理一啲 imagery 同埋一啲point cloud lidar data 嘅。咁譬如你手頭上面有好多唔同種類，或者越嚟越多啦，咁你要點樣去 manage 佢，同埋去做啲 visualization 啊，或者 analysis 咧？咁你都可以透過咧 image server 咧，去到做到呢個嘅 functions 嘅。咁第三個就係做 event server。做 event server 顧名思義就係我哋今日會講噶啦，就係會處理一啲實時或者係post-processing 或者 real time 嘅data feed 啦。咁佢可以做到接收完之後翻嚟放喺一個 database 齊齊整整放喺度，然後你再去做一啲 further analysis 嘅。咁第四個就係做 analytic server。做 analytic server 咧就可以提供一個平台俾你啦。譬如你手頭上有好多唔同種類嘅數據啦，咁你係日積月累嘅好多好多，咁你想去 insert 一啲 data 入邊所裡面嘅 information 咧？咁譬如你可以透過做 edit server 啦，去做一啲 patterns 或者一啲 trends 嘅，即係分析㗎。好，最後咧就係個 notebook server 啦。咁 notebook server 咧就係會提供一個平台俾你去寫一啲 Python script 啊，或者係做一啲API 嘅 Java scripting 嘅嘢。咁咧，從而可以有個平台俾你去做一啲 automation 嘅 workflow 啦，同埋可以 combine 一啲好簡單 combine 一啲 coding 啦。real time 嘅 coding 咧，去做一啲 visualization，咁你可以喺一个平台上面咧，一日可以做到晒嘅。好啦，究竟咩叫做 real time GIS 咧？咁我就将佢分咗做三个嘅范畴嘅。咁第一个啦，就系 stationary sensor 啦，即系我所讲嘅系一啲 static 嘅 sensor 啦。咁啊，例如系啲水掣啊、温度计啊、湿度计啊、风计啊，或者系啲 air quality 嘅 sensor，佢系全部系唔喐嘅。咁咧，佢就將佢個每可能佢每秒嘅 data feed 啦，咁佢 feed 翻嚟你哋 control center，咁啊，從而咧就可以知道個當其時嘅實際嘅環境情況嘅。咁第二類咧就係啲 dynamic 嘅 sensor 啦，咁啊 dynamic 嘅 sensor，例如係飛機啊、車啊、動物啊、人啊，甚至船啦。咁你當你每你呢啲會喐嘅聲，要喐嘅 object 咧，當你放咗啲譬如 GPS sensor 落去之後咧，你就可以每秒鐘 track 住佢哋嘅嗰個 movement 啦。咁呢個咧就係第二個類型嘅 dynamic 嘅 real-time data 啦。咁第三類咧就係話係一啲 instant 嚟嘅，係譬如係啲 lighting 啊、雷擊啊，咁係一嘢打落去咧，你知即刻 trigger 到一啲 on-off 嘅 switch 咧，咁你就知道哦，依個係有個 event 出現啦。好啦，大家會睇到個 map 上面咧，就會有啲重型機器嘅推土車啦。咁咧，依個就係一個 example 咧，就係 for 一啲會叫做 dynamic 嘅 sensor 啦，譬如 GPS sensor 就裝咗喺依啲推土車上面啦。咁佢收到 GPS 嘅 position 嘅時候咧，你就會見到佢嘅 movement 每秒鐘 real time 嘅 movement 啦。咁你會見到一條黃色嘅 track 咧，就係代表佢而家行緊每一秒鐘嘅 movement 啦，可以追蹤住佢嘅行徑啦。咁究竟ArcGIS Enterprise 佢點樣去work with 個 GeoEvent Server 咧？咁大家會見到左手邊咧就有一堆唔同類型，頭先我所講嘅dynamic 或者 static 嘅 sensor 啦，有風雞啊，有 instant 嘅雷擊啊，或者係有啲車嘅 movement 啊，或者係有啲水掣啦。咁佢呢啲咧全部咧就會由 GeoEvent Server 咧就啲每一秒鐘就食咗啲 sensor data 落嚟我哋個 GeoEvent Server 啦。咁我哋可以透過 GeoEvent Server 做啲 filtering 啊，或者做啲 analytic 嘅分析啦。咁咧就 save 咗落去我哋嘅 storage 度，放喺度齊齊整整啦。之後透過我哋個 ArcGIS Enterprise 咧，就可以 disseminate 或者係 share 去唔同嘅平台嘅上邊噶啦。咁當然啦，我哋可以透過一啲 actuation， 即係譬如話我哋會有啲 feedback 嘅。咁我哋唔會廿四小時坐喺度睇住成個 system 噶嘛。咁譬如我哋有啲alarm 啊、horn 啊，或者 email 啊，或者 SMS 咧，就可以透過 GeoEvent Server 咧呢個 actuation 咧就可以acknowledge 唔同嘅羣組啦。咁接住落嚟第二部分咧，就麻煩阿 Kenneth 咧同我哋講解一下一啲 key product 嘅 capabilities 啦。唔該曬 Kenneth。
唔該曬 Kelvin 啦。啱啱 Kelvin 都簡單介紹過 GeoEvent Server 啦，依家我就深入少少講一下 GeoEvent Server 嘅每個 key product capability 啦。而第一個主要功能咧就係 ingest data 啦。GeoEvent Server 咧就會喺唔同嘅 data provider 度拎 data 啦，例如可以喺有 GPS 嘅船、車、飛機。另外我哋都可以收集關於天氣嘅 data 啦，譬如温度、濕度，幾乎所有種類嘅 data 咧都可以 input 落 GeoEvent Server 度啦。好啦，收集完呢啲 data 之後咧，我哋就可以做 real-time analytics。而呢個 real-time analytics 咧就分咗兩類啦。第一個就係 filtering 啦。當我哋收集咗一堆高流量或者輸入速度好快嘅 data 之後咧，我哋最重要就喺呢堆 data 揾到我哋最想要嘅 data 啦。所以我哋就可以 set 翻一個 specify attribute values 去過濾我哋唔想要嘅 data 啦。就好似下面嗰個例子咁啦，佢就 set 咗個 value 係藍色同橙色。當唔符合呢啲依個 value 嘅其他顏色咧，就會篩走咗佢啦。另外啦 ，GeoEvent Server 咧都可以俾我哋做啲 test 係關於 spatial condition 嘅。而做呢個 test 嗰陣咧，我哋就可以喺個 polygon 度 set 翻個 GeoFence。而咩係 GeoFence 咧 ？GeoFence 就係一個虛擬嘅 branding 啦。當一個 object 入咗呢個 GeoFence 嗰陣咧，佢就會 pass 入唔到呢個 GeoFence 嘅話咧，佢就會篩走咗佢啦。而呢個 GeoFence 咧，唔一定要用喺 polygon 度嘅，都可以用翻喺我哋常見嘅 line 啦，同 point 度。我哋都可以做翻啲 test 啦，例如 destroy 啊，同 contain。跟住另外一種咧就係 processing 啦。而我哋呢個 GeoEvent Server 咧都有二十幾類 processor 啦，我就簡單介紹幾個常用嘅 processor 俾大家啦。第一個就係 Field Calculator 啦。而 Field Calculator 咧有咩用呢？佢就係可以用一啲 expression 計算我哋想要嘅 value 啦。而呢個 expression 咧都包括 stream 同埋數字同埋啲 field 啦。就好似下面嗰個例子咁啦，佢用咗駕駛者嘅 ID 啦，同埋架車嘅 ID 呢兩個 field 咧，去計算一個佢想要嘅 field 啦。之後到 field mapper 啦 ，field mapper 係咩咧 ？field mapper 咧就係喺一個 event record 嘅 schema 或者一個 structure 嗰度 translate 個 data 去另外一個 event record 度啦， 即係咩意思呢？就好似下面嗰個例子咁啦，佢個 ID 係本身係 integer 呢個 data type 嘅，之後佢就轉咗 string 嘅 data type 啦。另外咧，你都可以睇到其他 field 嘅名啦，佢都轉咗嘅。之後到 buffer creator 啦 ，buffer creator 咧即係喺圖案嘅周圍咧 create 一個 buffer， 而呢個 buffer 咧係 user 自己 set 嘅，個大細係自己 set 嘅，而呢個大細咧一定要係整數。好啦，分析完呢啲 data 之後咧，我哋就要揾個地方store 翻呢啲 data 啦。而主要嘅 output 嘅 data 咧都係會 store 喺翻 relational 嘅 geo database 啦，而一啲高流量或者輸入速度好快嘅 data 咧，就會 store 喺個 spatial temporal 嘅 big data store 度啦。好啦，到 visualization 啦。Geo database 嘅 feature service 咧都 support 啲RESTful 嘅 web application 同 API 啦。另外 big data 嘅 map 咧。同 feature service 都 support on the fly 嘅 feature aggregation 啦。另外，主要 event server 咧都有個 stream service 係 for 呢個 visualization 嘅。最後啦，我哋冇理由可以24小時咁樣望住個主要 event server 噶嘛。咁所以我哋就可以 set 翻，當呢個 object 離開咗一個主要 fans 嗰陣嘅話咧，佢就可以 send 個 email 咁樣通知翻個 user 啦。而呢個 email 咧係用 HTML 嘅 format create 嘅，所以咧你就可以 set 翻佢嘅內容啦，或者 send 去俾邊個 supervisor 度啦。另外咧，我哋都可以決定翻呢個 item 咧係 send 去邊個 cloud 度啦，譬如 AWS 啦，即係亞馬遜或者 Azure 啦。之後到 working with real-time data 啦。好多人都問我哋點樣將呢啲 data input 落呢個 Geo Event Server 度啦？其實我哋 Geo Event Server 咧就係透過唔同嘅 input connector 啦，咁樣 input 啲 data 落去嘅。譬如我哋可以喺 ArcGIS Online 或者 ArcGIS Enterprise 度 pull 呢啲 ArcMap 啊或者 feature service 去 update 啲 data 啦，同埋 pull 呢啲 external 嘅Web service 或者 Web server， 同埋透過 HTTP 或者 POST 去 receive 呢啲 data record 啦 ，subscribe to 呢個 external 嘅 Web socket 啦。另外啦，我哋可以睇翻個 system folder for 呢個 change to a file 啦。而啲 file 咧可以係 CSV 啦，或者 JSON 啦，或者 GeoJSON。同埋我哋都可以 subscribe to 呢個 avatar 嘅 topic 啦。另外，我哋 Esri 嘅官網咧都有啲 documentation 咧，可以提供翻俾大家。我哋都有個 documentation 咧，係講翻每個 input connector 咧係點樣用啦，詳細咁樣介紹翻佢嘅。另外咧，我哋 Esri 都有同其他公司 develop 啲input connector 咧，係俾 user 用嘅。除此之外，我哋Esri 咧都有用啲出名嘅 data source 啦，做 input connector 啦，譬如 Apache 啦，咁樣做啲input connector 嘅 sample 咧俾 user 用嘅。如果以上嘅 input connector 都唔啱用嘅話咧，你就可以透過 Geo Event Manager 或者 Java 嘅 SDK 咧 create 一個你想要嘅 input connector 啦。好啦 ，input 完咁，我哋點樣收翻啲data 咧？就要透過 output connector 啦。而我哋 output connector 咧，就有可以 add 或者 update 啲 feature 啦，或者同埋 update 個 spatial temporal 嘅 big data store 啦。另外，我哋可以 send 啲 features 去呢個 stream server 啦，同埋 push data record 去呢個 external 嘅 web socket 同埋 web socket。另外，我哋可以 send 啲test message 啊，威翻啲local file 啊，而呢啲 local file 都係同樣啦，都可以係 CSV 啊、JSON 啊或者 GeoJSON 嘅。 同埋都可以 raise to 呢個 Kafka 嘅 topic 啦。Open Connector 咧都同樣地啦，我哋嘅官網咧都有啲有個 documentation 咧講解翻每個 Open Connector 咧係點樣用嘅。而 Open Connector 咧都有 Esri 都有啲 sample 俾大家用嘅。如果以上嘅 Open Connector 都唔啱用嘅話，同樣地都可以透過 GeoEvent Manager 啦，或者 Java 嘅 SDK create 翻一個你想要嘅 Open Connector 啦。好啦，啱啱都簡單介紹過 Input Connector 同 Output Connector 啦，同埋啱啱我哋都講過啦，我哋 GeoEvent Server 咧有20多個 processor 啦，除咗我哋啱啱就係簡單介紹過嘅 Field Calculator 啦、Field Mapper 啦，跟住仲有 Buffer 嘅 Creator 啦，跟住另外我哋都有個叫做 Incident 嘅 Detector 啦。而呢個 Incident 嘅 Detector 咧有咩用呢？佢就可以你 set 翻啲條件啦。當呢個 record 係符合呢啲條件嘅話咧，佢就會 detect 到啦。咁有咩用呢？咁你就可以，譬如可以你可以用喺個超速呢個 case 度嘅。另外我哋喺 10.7 嗰陣咧，都加咗幾個 processor 啦，譬如可以 add 呢個 XY set 嘅 value 啦，同埋 features 轉去呢個 pom 度啦。另外我哋都整咗啲 sample 俾 user 用嘅。如果以上嘅 processor 咧都唔啱用嘅話咧，我哋都可以用 Java 嘅 SDK create 一個你想要嘅 processor 啦。好啦，到 filter 啦 ，filter 我哋都有啲 attribute filter 啦，例如大於啊、低於啊、大過啊、等於啊嗰啲 filter 俾 user 用嘅。另外啦，啱啱都講過啦，做 event server 咧都可以俾你做啲 spatial condition 嘅 test 嘅。除咗啱啱提及過喺入邊啦，同埋出邊啦，跟住仲有都唔同嘅 spatial filter 俾大家用嘅。同樣啦，我哋都可以用翻啲 test 啊，或者 regular 嘅 expression 咧，去 config 翻呢啲 filter 啦。好啦，咁究竟我哋今年做 event server 10.8 咧，有咩重大更新咧？做 event server 咧 10.8 咧，除咗喺穩定性方面咧，係比之前提升咗啦，仲有最重要嘅更新咧，就係佢比較方便啦。喺10.8嗰陣咧。我哋就可以喺 GeoEvent Service 呢個 page 度咧，可以直接 create 同 add 新嘅 input connector 啦，同埋 output connector 啦，同埋可以 edit input connector 入邊啲嘢，同埋 output connector 入邊啲嘢啦。另外，我哋都多咗一個新嘅 application 啦，就係 GeoEvent Sample 啦 ，Sampler 啦。而呢個 GeoEvent Sampler 咧，就可以睇到。publish 咗嘅 GeoEvent Service 咧入邊嘅資料啦，就好似下邊咁樣咯，可以睇到入邊佢嘅 detail 啦。跟住喺10.8.1嘅話咧，就多咗一個叫 monitoring 嘅 page 啦。而呢個 monitoring 嘅 page 咧係咩咧？佢係將 monitor 同埋 input output service 呢個 page 咧合埋一齊啦。咁樣 user 嘅話就唔使瀏覽咁多個網，瀏覽咁多個 page 咁樣可以控制所有 input 同埋 output 啦。另外，我哋喺呢個 monitoring 嘅 page 度咧，都可以 filter to 搜曬所有item 出嚟啦。無論佢係開始啊或者 stop 咗嘅 item 咧，佢都可以搜曬出嚟嘅。同埋佢嘅通知 style 都轉咗啦，變咗 to style 啦。咁樣就會唔會阻止到in application 嘅 messaging？ 最後啦，喺 input 同埋 output 嘅 creation 嘅 workflow 咧都改善咗啦。以前喺 GeoEvent Server 嘅話咧，佢就會 input 同埋 output connector 咧，佢都會由英文字母咁樣順序咁樣 show 曬出嚟嘅。但係而家喺10.8.1嘅話咧，佢就會喺一頁 show 曬只可以用到嘅 input。同埋 Open Connector 啦，咁樣就會方便 user 咁樣使用啦。好啦，之後就交俾Jonathan 咁樣講解下 GeoEvent Server 嘅 demo 啦。
好，唔該 Kenneth 啦，咁大家好啦，咁我係 Jonathan 啦。咁 咁以下落嚟呢個環節咧，我就會 show 兩個 demo 俾大家睇，咁 showcase 下我哋 GeoEvent 嘅一啲用法啦，同埋一啲簡單嘅 example 咁樣嘅。咁我哋第一個 demo 咧就係關於游泳池嘅水質監控啦。咁個 scenario 就係話，咁假設我哋喺全港唔同嘅泳池，每一個泳池都有一個 stationary 嘅 sensor 去測一啲譬如 chemical 嘅含量咁樣。咁我哋點樣先可以將嗰啲 data 去 visualize 出嚟，又或者儲埋咧咁樣？咁喺開始之前，咁我先介紹一下我哋 GeoEvent Server 嘅界面啦。咁呢個就係我哋嘅 Service Monitor， 咁其實就係我哋嘅主界面。咁喺上面咧，其實就會見到曬所有 service 啦、input 啦、output 啦咁樣嘅。咁除此之外咧，佢亦都會提供翻一啲基本嘅 statistic 俾我哋嘅，譬如話已經有幾多個坑啊。佢個 rate per second 啊，佢上一次幾時收到一個 GeoEvent 啊，一啲 graph 啊咁樣嘅。咁另外你亦都可以喺度控制，譬如話 start 啊、stop 啊、restart 一啲唔同嘅 service 嘅。咁你要做一個 GeoEvent service 啦，咁你首先第一步就係要先 create 一個 GeoEvent 嘅 definition。咁其實咧個 GeoEvent 嘅 definition 咧就係要 define 一個 data structure 俾個 GeoEvent。咁除咗話最基本嘅 name 同埋 type 之外咧，咁其實 GeoEvent 仲需要有啲唔同嘅 tags 嘅。咁譬如話最常用嘅可能有 track ID 啊、geometry 啊或者 time start 咁樣。咁 track ID 咧其實即係我哋等於我哋平時用開嘅 identifier field 啦，即係或者 key field 啦。咁就係攞嚟話俾個 GeoEvent server 聽，攞邊個嚟做 key 嚟去 update 翻其他 data 嘅。咁 geometry 顧名思義就係佢個 location 啦。咁 time start 咧，亦都係方便做一啲時間嘅統計咁樣嘅。咁除咗你話喺個網站度自己撳 new 去 create 逐個入咧，如果你有啲現成嘅 GeoEvent definition 咧，你亦都可以透過 import 呢個 function 咧，去直接放落去嘅。咁當前面嗰兩嘢都準備好嘅時候咧，就可以開始整一個 input connector 啦。咁我哋好似頭先 Kenneth 都介紹過啦，我哋 GeoEvent server 咧，其實係有好多唔同種類嘅。input connector 去俾大家使用嘅，咁最常用嘅可能就會有 TCP web socket 啊、REST endpoint 啊，又或者 POL、receive JSON、XML、GeoJSON 等等嘅。咁喺今次呢個sample入邊咧，我哋就會用最簡單嘅 receive text from TCP socket 啦。咁你只需要 specify 翻邊個 server port 同埋佢用緊邊個嘅 GeoEvent definition 咧，咁就可以噶啦。咁至於 output 方面啦，咁同樣地 output connector 咧都有好多唔同嘅選擇嘅。咁最常用嘅分別有 update feature layer 啦、stream surface 啦同埋 notification 嘅。咁喺呢個 demo 入面咧，我哋就會用 update feature。咁同之前差唔多啦。咁由於我哋 GeoEvent server 咧係會攬埋一套 ArcGIS server， 咁就只要揀翻喺上面 ArcGIS server 上面 host 咗嘅 feature layer 咧。然後再揀翻一個 layer 入邊嘅 field 做 identifier field 咧，咁其實就可以噶啦。咁最後尾咧就係會當你將所有嘢都準備好嘅時候咧，你就可以開始去 create 一個 GeoEvent service 啦。咁喺我哋 GeoEvent service 呢個界面咧，其實就係一個 drag and drop 嘅 GUI interface 嘅。咁你只需要將所有嘅 input connector 啦、output connector 啦同埋其他嘅嘢連埋就得噶啦。咁今次我哋呢個 example 就比較簡單啦，所以只需要將一個 input 拉條線過去 output 度就得㗎啦。但係譬如話複雜少少嘅 GeoEvent 咧，可能就會用到 filtering 啦，去 filter 一啲多餘嘅資訊啦，又或者係 processor， 譬如話你 field mapper 咁樣，譬如話你喺網上面攞落嚟嘅 data， 同埋你而家喺個 server 上面啲 data 啲名唔同嘅話咧，咁你就可以用個 field mapper 去重新 remap 過去，令到佢可以都 update 到啦。咁喺度我特別提一提啦，咁呢個其實 GeoEvent Simulator 咧就係一個 debugging 同埋 testing 嘅 tool 嚟嘅，咁佢就係一個 Windows application 嚟嘅，咁佢就可以透過將啲 dot CSV 咧就轉做一啲 GeoEvent data， 就透過 TCP socket 咁樣 send 出去嘅。咁除咗話佢可以逐行將啲 data send 出去之外咧，佢亦都可以將啲 data associate 去而家嗰個時間，咁喺 testing 同埋喺一個 development 嘅環境度咧係十分之有用嘅。咁而喺以下落嚟嗰兩個 demo 咧，啲 data 就會係用呢個 tools 嚟去 simulate 啦。咁講咗咁耐啦，咁其實而家呢個咧就會係我哋嘅 feature layer。咁其實呢個就係一個 host 咗喺我哋 host 喺我哋 ArcGIS server 嘅一個 feature layer。咁入邊咧其實就係全香港唔同泳池嘅 point 嚟嘅。咁除咗話你有個咁嘅 layer 佢 update 完，咁除咗可以做一個 web map 嘅 visualization 之外咧，其實亦都可以 integrate 去我哋 ArcGIS 唔同嘅 product 度嘅。咁譬如話一個 dashboard 啦，咁相信大家都可能會見過呢種咁嘅 dashboard。咁 dashboard 咧就可以有少少唔同嘅 element 啊，又或者可以將啲比較重要嘅一啲 data 就放大嚟睇啦，咁就可以方便 user 有個好 smooth 嘅 experience 去了解到啲 data 噶啦。咁講咗咁多啦，咁我俾大家睇一睇啦。咁首先咧，咁大家都見到啦，呢個其實就係 publish 咗喺我哋 ArcGIS Server 上面嘅 layer 啦。咁我哋喺 portal 上面開到嚟睇嘅。咁如果你去睇翻 data 嗰度咧，其實佢就係一個好簡單、好普通嘅一個 point data 啦。咁分別就係譬如話有啲 basic 嘅嗰啲名啊、地址啊嗰啲 data。咁而 update 嗰啲 field 咧，我就已經包埋咗喺後面噶啦。譬如話有啲 pH value 啊、total bacteria 啊、大腸桿菌啊咁樣嗰啲。咁咧個 GeoEvent Server 就會對翻個 key value 咧，然之後 update 翻後面嗰啲唔同 chemical 嘅數目啦。咁喺個 GeoEvent Server 度啦，呢度就我頭先講嘅主界面啦。咁第一步咧，其實就係要 create 一個 definition 先嘅。咁你撳 Site 啦，然之後再撳 GeoEvent Definition 咧，第一個就已經係噶啦。咁呢度你可以 New 啦、Import 或者 Delete 嘅。我哋係用緊一個本身已經有噶啦，咁我就俾大家睇一睇我哋嗰個 definition。咁其實個 definition 咧，其實都 OK 簡單嘅啫。最主要咧就係同頭先睇到嗰個 layer 上面啲 field 咧一模一樣名嘅。咁咧你只要 set 翻佢哋個名啦，佢哋個 type 啦，咁就得噶啦。咁由於我哋今次咧係攞個 facility name 嚟做佢個 unit field 咧，咁只要需要喺後面加翻個 track ID 嘅 tag 咧，咁就可以噶啦。咁跟住落嚟咧，就可以去開始 configure 我哋嘅 input connector 啦。咁喺 input 方面啦，你一撳個 add input 咧，你就會見到其實我哋係有好多唔同類型嘅 input connector 可以俾大家用嘅。咁喺今次入邊咧，我哋就會用 receive text from 一個 TCP socket 嘅。咁時間關係啦，咁我已經 create 咗一個喺度啦，咁我帶大家睇一睇入邊。其實佢咧都相對十分之簡單嘅啫，你只需要喺 specify 翻佢想喺邊個 server port 嗰度收到嗰啲 data， 同埋揀翻頭先我哋 create 咗嗰個 geo definition 咧，咁就 OK 噶啦。咁 output 方面啦，啲操作都係大同小異啦。同樣地，你可以喺 add output 呢粒掣嗰度揾到我哋好多唔同種類嘅 output connector 啦。而在今次的 demo 入面，我們就用了一個 update feature 的 output connector。剛才也都提到一下，它 update feature 那個 feature 就會是需要在我們 register 了的 ArcGIS Server 上的。我們今次就會用一個 hold， 已經 hold 在我們 ArcGIS Server， 就是我們剛才看到的 layer， 你就會看到在上面呢，你揀翻嗰個 layer 所在嘅 folder 啦，同埋個 surface name 咧，你會見到依度有好多我哋嘅 surface name。揀翻你想要嗰、那個，然之後揀翻個 layer， 揀翻一個佢哋嗰邊嘅 key field 咧，咁就可以噶啦。咁當 input 同 output 都 set 好嘅時候咧，就可以開始去 create 我哋嘅 GeoEvent Service 啦。咁 GeoEvent Service 咧，剛才都提到啦，因為我哋今次比較簡單啦，所以其實只要好簡單咁樣將佢哋兩個拉埋一齊，咁樣拉條線過去咧，咁其實就可以噶啦。咁最後啦，咁如果當所有嘢都整完嘅時候咧，咁 data 就會開始自己去 update 啦。咁呢度我都帶大家睇一睇啦。咁其實呢個就係我哋個 GeoEvent Simulator 啦。咁因為呢部係直接部 server 機啦，所以我揀翻 local host， 然之後揀翻個port 位，跟住再 import 翻啲 data 落去咧，跟住再撳粒 play 掣咧，咁其實啲嘢就會入到去噶啦。咁呢個就係我哋今次會用到嘅 test data 啦。咁你就會見到其實就係一個 CSV file， 咁就有唔同 chemical 嘅數目咁樣。咁呢度咧 set 好曬之後咧，再撳 play 咧，就係呢個。咁其實就會見到佢一直都喺度 fit 緊啲 data 過去個 server 度噶啦。 咁當所有嘢都準備好嘅時候咧，咁我就可以俾大家睇一睇個成品啦。咁呢個就係我哋嘅將佢砌好咗，變咗做 web map， 然之後再將個 web map 放咗入去個 dashboard 度嘅話咧，就可以大概見到係呢個樣子啦。咁可以見到啦，可以將所有啲譬如話唔同嘅 chemical 啊，就可以用一個 gauge 嘅形式去 show 出嚟啦。咁另外亦都 support 譬如話一啲 list view 啊，又或者一啲簡單嘅 chart 咁樣嘅。咁另外佢都提供咗一啲譬如話 interactive 嘅 element 啦，咁你可以譬如話你撳落去可以 show 到唔同嘅地方啦，你亦都可以 pan 去一啲唔同嘅特定 location 啊，咁樣就可以俾到一個好 smooth 嘅 experience 啲 user 噶啦。咁以上呢個咧就係我哋第一個 demo。咁喺第二個 demo 方面咧，我哋就會模擬一個 childcare 嘅 service。咁喺而家呢個年代啦，其實基本上每個人，譬如小朋友咁樣，手入邊都應該會有部電話嘅。咁如果我哋可以攞到嗰部電話嘅一啲 GPS 嘅 data， 咁我哋又可以用嗰個 data 嚟砌啲咩咧？咁樣，咁以下落嚟呢個 demo 咧就會 show 一 show 俾大家 GeoEvent 可以做到嘅一啲 capability 啦。咁喺呢個 demo 入邊咧，我哋就會用到 GeoFans 嘅。咁 GeoFans 其實就係一個 arbitrary 嘅 boundary 啦，咁我哋就可以用佢嚟做一啲 real time 嘅 spatial analysis 嘅。咁同樣地啦，咁個 GeoFans 咧就係要喺一個 register 咗嘅 ArcGIS server 上面 import 落嚟嘅。咁佢亦都 support 一個 dynamic 嘅 GeoFans， 即係譬如話你嗰個 layer 可能佢會又會 update 一次咁樣嘅。咁個 GeoEvent server 咧，你 set 好曬啲 setting 咧，佢亦都可以去到每一分鐘咁樣去升翻埋。去攞翻個 ArcGIS server 嘅嗰個 polygon 嚟做一個 GeoFans 嘅。咁喺 output 方面啦，咁今次除咗話我哋用 update feature 之外咧，我哋亦都用咗一個 notification， 就係 send an email 啦。咁佢其實都提供咗一個好簡單嘅界面俾我哋去 customize 一啲 email 嘅 input 同 output 嘅。咁你只需要入翻啲好基本嘅資料啦，譬如話 sender 啊、receiver 啊、subject 啊咁樣。咁而喺個 message 嗰度咧，你亦都可以去 customize 一啲，譬如話 input 嘅 field 啊，咁樣可以將佢 embed 落去都得嘅。咁你只要最後尾咧 specify 翻佢個 SMTP 咧，咁以我哋公司為例啦，咁我哋公司係用緊 Office 365嘅，咁只要放翻 Office 365嘅 SMTP server 一啲普通嘅資料咧，再加埋你個 account 密碼等等咧，咁其實佢就可以用嗰個 account 嚟收發一啲 email 噶啦。咁喺個 surface mapping 嗰度啦，咁今次就會用到兩個 incident detector 啦，同埋有三個唔同嘅 output 嘅。咁畫面所見啦，咁其實橙色嘅咧就會係我哋嘅 incident detector， 就好似我哋 programming 嘅 if loop 咁樣啦。咁就係話，譬如如果佢離開或者離開學校或者翻到屋企嘅話咧，咁佢就會 trigger 到我哋嘅嗰個 incident detector， 就係當佢個 geometry 離開咗或者 enter 咗嗰個 geofence 咧。咁就會去執行佢哋指住落去嗰兩個嘅 action 㗎啦。咁咧，除咗話 in out 一啲 geofence 之外咧，其實個 incident detector 都可以 detect 一啲 value 嘅，即係譬如話你一架揸緊嘅車咁啦，佢超速嘅話，譬如話佢時速超過50咧，亦都可以嚟作為一個 incident detector 嘅 switch 咁樣嘅。咁呢個就係我哋用到嘅第一個 layer 啦，就會係一個 geofence 嘅 feature layer。咁畫面所見啦，就會見到藍色嘅咧就係代表緊一個學校啦，咁紫色嘅咧就係代表緊佢屋企咁樣嘅。咁第二個 layer 咧就會用嚟indicate 個小朋友啦，我哋呢度叫阿 Tom 啦，咁嘅佢嘅 location 咁樣嘅。咁嗰個 feature layer 咧就會主要係利用嚟 update 佢嘅 location。咁而最後一個 layer 咧就會係攞嚟 update 一啲 incident 嘅。咁我哋就 set 咗啦，譬如話佢會離開學校或者會翻到屋企嘅時候咧。咁都會更新一次佢最後尾嘅時間咁樣。咁當將所有嘢砌埋一齊嘅時候咧，咁就可以做到一個好簡單嘅 childcare service 㗎啦。咁跟住嚟，我俾大家睇一睇啦。咁畫面見到啦，咁呢個其實就係我哋嘅 GeoFence layer 啦，咁好簡單兩個 polygon 嚟嘅啫。咁呢個咧就會係我哋攞嚟 save 個小朋友 location 嘅一個 layer， 咁亦都冇乜特別嘅。咁呢個咧就會係我哋用嚟 record 一啲 incident 嘅 layer。 係啦，咁將所有嘢砌埋一齊嘅時候咧，就可以見到呢個 web map 啦。咁由於呢個 web map 都要啲時間去俾大家睇啦，咁我先放埋一邊啦。咁就等大家可以睇到。咁呢個時候咧，咁我就可以介紹下我哋今次用到嘅一啲新 function 啦。咁同樣地啦，就要先 declare 一個 GeoEvent 嘅 definition 啦。咁我喺度就 develop 咗，咁就整咗兩個，譬如話 incident 啊，或者 char 咁樣。咁其實都係根據翻你個 feature layer 咧，就去入翻啲 field 落去嘅啫。咁喺 GeoEvent 方面咧，咁畫面都見到，其實我已經 create 咗兩個 GeoEvent， 一個就係 home 啦，另一個就係 school 咁樣嘅。咁你都可以喺呢度 import 一啲自己嘅 GeoEvent 啦。咁同樣地，你就係會揀翻喺你個 ArcGIS Server 上面嘅一啲 layer 啦。咁你只要揀翻好咧，對翻咧，咁就可以噶啦。咁兩樣嘢都 set 好咗之後咧，咁就可以去 set input 同 output 啦。咁喺 input 方面咧，咁同樣地啦，我哋都係會由一個 TCP socket 嗰度去 receive 嘅，咁都冇乜特別嘅啫。就係好簡單咁樣揀翻一個 port， 然之後揀翻我哋會用到嘅 GeoEvent definition， 咁就可以噶啦。咁至於喺 output 方面咧，咁我哋就 create 咗幾個唔同嘅 output 啦。咁我哋第一個 child care 嘅 output 咧，就係攞嚟 record 我哋小朋友喐嘅嗰個 layer 嘅。咁 incident 咧就係攞嚟去 update 我哋兩個唔同兩支旗仔啦，咁嗰個嘅時間嘅。咁另外咧，我哋亦都 create 咗一個攞嚟 send email 嘅一個output connector 啦，咁呢個俾大家睇一睇。咁其實咧個內容好簡單，就係、是、簡單啲嚟講，就係你只要放一翻啲基本資料，譬如話個 sender、個 recipient、個 subject 啊咁樣咧，同埋啲內容咧，咁就可以噶啦。咁你喺 advanced 嗰度咧，你只要打翻你 SMTP 嘅一啲基本資料咧，咁個 server 就會自己去幫你 send 嗰個 email 出噶啦。咁當所有嘢都整好之後咧，咁就可以開始砌我哋嘅 GeoEvent Service 啦。好啦，因為佢比較大啦，咁我稍微收埋呢個先。咁呢度咧見到就會見到係呢個就係我哋嘅 GeoEvent Service 啦。咁我就再詳細介紹一下啦。咁首先呢個 TCP Text In 咧，其實就會係我哋嘅 Data Source 啦。咁佢就會透過我哋嘅 TCP socket 咧，將啲 JSON 咁樣抌去個 server 度嘅。咁當我哋個 GeoEvent server 收到呢啲咁嘅 data 嘅時候咧，佢就會 update 去我哋 child care 嘅呢個 layer 啦，就會係 update 我哋小朋友嘅 location。咁與此同時咧，嗰兩個 data 亦都會 pass 去我哋嘅 incident detector 度嘅。咁當佢 fulfill 到我哋個 incident detector 嘅條件，即係譬如話佢離開學校又或者翻到屋企嘅時候咧，咁呢嗰啲 data 咧又會再另外 add 落去我哋嘅 incident 嗰個 layer 度。咁另外啦，如果佢翻到屋企嘅時候咧，除咗 trigger 埋個 incident 嗰個之外咧，佢都會 trigger 到我哋嘅 email 嗰個 layer， 咁咧就會 send 一個 email 去我哋個 email 度啦。呢個都見到啦。咁其實當佢行到去屋企嘅時候咧，咁其實就會 send 到個 email 去我哋度。咁我依度可以睇下，咁等一陣咧，佢行到過去嘅時候咧，咁呢度就應該會有新 email 嚟噶啦。咁喺我哋等緊嘅同時咧，咁我可以同大家介紹一下，其實我哋咧 Esri 咧其實都有好多 useful 嘅 resources 喺個 internet 度嘅。咁譬如話喺我哋enterprise.ArcGIS.com/en/GeoEvent 啦，咁喺呢個網址入邊咧，你會揾到好多關於 GeoEvent server 嘅一啲 documentation。咁亦都會有一啲 installation 加又或者 system requirement 嘅，而入邊都有啲簡單嘅 tutorial 咧，去幫你上手嘅。咁除咗話一啲 official 嘅 documentation 方面咧，我哋亦都有一啲 community driven 嘅 forum 啦，咁可以透過而喺條 link 去睇嘅。咁除此之外，如果你話想有啲 video 可以容易啲去了解咧，喺 esri.com/video 咧都有唔少嘅 technical workshop 你可以去望一望。好啦。誒，記得點解未喎？誒，我唔記得 start 翻佢 ，start 翻佢之後咧，過一陣應該就會收到啲 email 噶啦。 咁可能都仲需要少少時間先行到一個來回，咁我哋不如開始繼續我哋下一 part 先，一陣間再翻嚟睇翻嗰個 email 咧。我交俾 Kelvin 去講一講我哋 Q&A section 先。
好，唔該晒阿 Kenneth 同阿 Jonathan 啊，咁精彩嘅 demonstration 同埋解釋啊。咁啊，接住落嚟咧，我哋有一個 Q&A 嘅問答環節，大家可以利用畫面右手邊嘅 chat room 輸入你嘅問題，我哋會一一解答嘅。好，有條問題咧，就係話，究竟 GeoEvent handle 到有幾多個 data volume 嘅咧？能夠 handle 到幾多咧？阿 Jonathan 可唔可以幫手答答唔得？
好，咁關於呢個問題咧，其實就 depends on 我哋個 GeoEvent 嘅 data sizing 啦。咁以一個 single instance 即係單頭嘅 GeoEvent server 為例啦，咁其實佢每秒係可以處理到6000個 GeoEvent 嘅。咁但係你話如果個 GeoEvent 啲 sizing，即係譬如話佢啲 data size 比較大，譬如有好多個 field，又或者係一啲好 multi size 嘅 polygon 嘅話咧，咁每秒可能淨係處理到2000個 event。咁你都要睇翻個 network 啦，同埋個 GeoEvent 個本身啲 hardware 嘅。咁其實最主要咧，都係睇翻唔同情況。咁但係都可以話翻俾你聽咧，就係佢都可以處理到 OK 多嘅 data 啦。
好，唔該曬啊，Jonathan。好，接住落嚟就第二條問題咧，就係咧，究竟 GeoEvent server 順唔 support resilient 嘅 setup 咧？Jonathan 唔該。
咁 GeoEvent server 咧係 support 一個 multi machine 嘅 setup 嘅。咁如果你話想追求一個 resilience 嘅話咧，其實你可以將幾部 server 拼埋一齊，就每部機都做一個 GeoEvent server 去 form 一個 GeoEvent server 嘅 cluster。咁喺呢個情況下咧，就會係一個 resilient 嘅 setup 啦。咁除此之外咧，亦都係我哋 GeoEvent server 都係 highly scalable 嘅。即係你覺得如果佢個效能唔夠嘅話咧，你可以再額外再加多啲 server 上去都得嘅。咁希望咁樣解答到呢個問題啦。
好，唔該曬啊，Jonathan。好，第三條問題啦，就係咁，我哋建架deploy做 van server 啦，咁要唔要係咪一定要有ArcGIS Enterprise 嘅咧？唔該Kenneth。
如果要用到 GeoEvent Server 嘅話咧，一定要有一個 basic 嘅 ArcGIS Enterprise 啦，即係要有個 portal 啦、ArcGIS Server 啦、同埋 Red Data 啦、同埋 Data Store 嘅。再補充翻少少啦，有啲客可能會問，如果有個 ArcGIS Enterprise 10.7.1嘅話，可唔可以用10.8嘅 GeoEvent Server 咧？係唔可以嘅，因為佢哋嘅 version 咧一定要 match 嘅。
咁啲時間都應該過得差唔多啦，咁我就 show 翻俾大家睇頭先嗰啲 email 嗰度，係啦，呢邊呢個，呢度啦，就會見到咧，佢翻咗一次屋企嘅時候咧，即係上次係43分翻到去咧，咁喺43分嗰邊咧，其實就會 send 咗個 email 去，喺嗰一刻就話俾你聽佢翻到屋企咁樣得啦。好，我交翻俾 Kelvin 去繼續我哋嘅環節。
如果大家有啲咩問題咧，就可以 send email 去我哋個 event at svchina.hk，咁我哋會有專責嘅同事咧就回答回覆俾大家嘅。好，之後咧就同大家講講我哋嚟緊啊sales and marketing 咧有啲咩新嚟緊嘅 event 啦。咁就係一個叫 5-minute lunch GIS takeaway。咁簡單嚟講咧就係一個 user conference 嘅 product feature highlight。咁啊，我都知大家比較忙㗎啦，好難話係花到可能一個鐘頭坐喺度聽我哋講呢啲technology update 啊咁樣。咁所以咧，我哋為大家咧就有呢啲update 咧同重點嘅 features 就俾大家嘅。咁你大家如果對譬如話有啲咩新嘅 features 咧想了解咧，就譬如話好似 LogXT 啦，咁我哋喺我哋 Address Pool 你只要打一個地址落去咧，就 refer 翻個 coordinate 嚟㗎啦。咁啊，譬如仲有啲叫 AutoDesk 嘅 integration 啦，咁我哋同 AutoDesk 咧已經係 alliance 噶啦，咁我哋有更加多嘅 integration 咧，可以同大家去分享嘅。咁就如果大家對呢個topic 有啲咩興趣咧，可以咧掃描左手邊個 QR code，咁我哋就 register 之後咧，我哋就會有條 link 咧俾你落，俾你去慢慢嚟享用翻呢個嘅 topic 噶啦。 咁另外啦，我哋仲有好多唔同 instruction lead 嘅 training program 啦，佢唔同 basic 啦、advanced level 都可以俾大家選擇嘅，只要去翻我哋嗰、那個、training 嘅 page 啦，去揀選翻適合你哋嘅 training level 嘅 training 嘅。咁又係啦，如果大家對於有咩關於我哋嘅 product 上啊，或者係同個 training 嘅問題咧，都可以 send email 嚟我哋個 event@esri.china.hk 嘅。之後咧，我想同大家講講我哋唔同嘅 social media 啦，都會不定期咁放啲 resource 響我哋唔同嘅 media 上面俾大家去 register 嘅。咁譬如話我哋 YouTube 啦，會放曬所有我哋之前 webinar record 俾大家隨時去重温嘅。咁另外啦，響 Facebook 啊、Instagram 啊、LinkedIn 咧，都希望大家咧見到我哋嘅 event 咧，都係俾個 like 我哋啦。好啦，今日嘅 webinar 咧已經嚟到尾聲啦。多謝大家抽空出席，我哋咧稍後咧就會將呢個 webinar 嘅 record 片段啦 email 翻俾大家 read 咗俾大家嘅客户嘅，咁啊好，多謝曬，唔該，拜拜。